very wall. And I'm not talking about the black belts, I'm talking about your face.
God damn. Sim.
Sim.
O Comex.
The wacky.
The wacky,
yeah.
Okay, guys, one more year, boy. And I cannot even believe every time this wall is getting... We're going to have to move soon, you know? The wall is getting shorter. You know, and the good thing is I know... Is this thing working? Yeah. I'm screaming.
Huh?
Hello, hello. Ah, yeah. Now we're talking. Where was I?
Long and short.
Yeah. The truth is, one day I'm going to see all of you guys on that side. You know, for sure we're going to have a lot of white belts on that side too. And it's enriching, you know, not only to see when we have this ceremony here, but when we have the competition and I see all of you guys competing and representing our team, you know. For some reason, Black Rock feels better with this than me. I'm a Black Rock. So thank God one more year, you know, and a lot of good guys are going to receive that belt today. And you guys make me proud every single time, you know. And I still remember the time that I could come in class and train with everybody on the same class. And I think that's impossible today, you know. Probably you guys, half of you kick my butt too, you know, so it wouldn't look good. But thank you for coming, boy, and thanks for supporting. It's an honor, you know. I'm not giving you guys this belt. You guys earned it. You know, I'm just handing it to you. So let's start with the name.
Amazed that I have as many stripes as I have IQ points. Renzo, thanks very much. A wonderful evening. And I'm looking out at that line of black belts, and it's incredible the people you've produced over the years. And as you said earlier, it's only a matter of time until you guys move over to this side of the room. And I know that in years from now, you will represent this school with the same kind of elegance and pride as the men standing there now. Thank you very much.
Methadone clinic on 37th Street, you know? And I still remember the look of the students when we moved here. They came in the door, they looked, they walked back. They said, this gotta be the wrong place, it can't be here. You know, and that place was really a nut job, a nut house, I'm sorry. And I remember, like in my conception, in Brazil, drugs was something light. Would be an alcoholic or something like this. And when the woman told me, that's a methadone clinic. I never heard that. I said, what is methadone? She goes, I said, like a drug. I said, like an AA. Or she goes, yeah. I said, oh, no problem. I'll fit right in. That's the first time I realized there was more crazy people out there than us, you know? And the elevator used to open right on our floor, you know. So I was, every time the elevator popped open, I always look on the corner of my eye because I knew it could be some problem. So it doesn't matter. I was showing a move, the elevator open, I look. One of those looks, I see this guy arriving that I didn't see him for a few years. And he's arriving with holding hands with the girl. He came in. And that gentleman was Zay. He walks in, holds this girl's hand. I say, Zay, look, it's been like 6 or 7 years that I don't see you. Man, it's nice. How long you stay in New York? Forever. I go, forever, that's nice. It's nice to train here with us. Yes. I come to train with you guys and to teach here with you, work with you, be here forever. I can play the academy, I can do this, I can do that. At the same time, the girl goes, oh, could you please translate? For how long he'll be here? I go, she doesn't know, yeah, how long you're gonna be here in Portuguese? He goes, not yet. I go to her, Zed, where are you? At her house. And she goes again, well, how long is he staying? Could you ask him? I say, well, why are you asking that? And she goes, because he came to my house with at least 9 luggage, those big luggage. And nobody travels for a short time with that amount of luggage. Through like a year and a half, I was the mediator. Every time they had a problem, both would come and I would be the translator and fix things up in the middle, you know? This fellow is with us for that long. He learned, he finally learned to speak English. Has the most incredible stories ever, and you know, he's one of the most pleasant guys that we are actually having here. Come get your belt.
Just to start, I'm not used to talking like this. Just to start, I'm black belt.
We went. You see, we went to take some pictures for the website and this and that. He goes to me, Jesus, let me be the model, please. I say, of course. Let's do the picture. So he's always very relaxed, you know, chilling. We put the clothes on him. I say, okay, pose.
Like this.
Change clothes, pose! You remember those, huh? We couldn't use the pictures. You know, we could not. The guy that was organizing the site, he goes, Renzo, I don't think he likes me.
But to be a model for the ugly. Okay, guys, just to let you know, I'm a black belt. My English, maybe almost purple.
Red and black. Everybody understands you.
So, as then, he told everybody, when I made a project to come in here without him knowing I was coming, I thought, yeah, I'm going to talk with Hans. He didn't know. And oh, I'm going to see that academy. By the time I have a special friend here. Very nice. And just to resume my relation with her. Was for a short time. One for 2 weeks and a half.
I'm gonna hit him with her for a year and a half. Every week she wanna kick him out, she can talk to me. I convinced her we can't let him, but it's too cold outside.
In 2 weeks, I told her, I brought my dictionary to find the letter like, I like you, my sister.
I like you like a sister.
And she put me to sleep with the dog. Thank God. The dog was my hands with the dog.
Was my best friend.
Was my best friend ever. She realized I was a nice guy, he was telling the truth. And she let me to sleep for free. But I had to do her bed, breakfast, clean the house, everything. I was teasing me, but I couldn't.
Thank God for jiu-jitsu!
And never forget, guys, a black belt is a white belt who never quits. Perseverance, believe in yourself, you know, be a Labrador, be a pitbull, smart pitbull inside, and Labrador, like Renzo, the number one Labrador, smiling for everybody, but don't touch too much, otherwise, it's a pitbull bite.
To keep the Amazon, we need to have the acai. It was not only a healthy berry, but it would be saving the Amazon forest. So all the jiu-jitsu guys exactly like you, back when Igor's dad was teaching us, that changed the habits and the ways of eating to make people healthier and better, you know? And not only that, but the opportunity to give jobs. Most of these guys can work with jiu-jitsu, you know? I remember when the real estate market was doing incredible, you know, I had friends doing very good. And one day he called me and I tell him, open a school so you can train. Just open a school so you can train. You know, today I think is the main revenue that he has on his life, you understand? Is from your jiu-jitsu school in Florida. You know, I'm extremely happy for that. I'm happy to see you here. You know, and a couple weeks back, I got a text saying that the guy wouldn't be able to be here because he'll be busy. But he sent me a picture of this boot. This is a boot that one of you guys used to work at night and he had to support himself to be here. I never charged the prick, just to let you guys know. His name was Matt Sierra, you know. So he went there, took this picture. Today he has a beautiful house, you know, he represents us everywhere he goes. And that what actually makes me very happy to be teaching you guys here. You guys have this school that I dreamed having when I was a kid, you know, and I'm glad to be part of that. So let's take a picture now for everybody together.